Friends, Tinkercad just gave us a brand new tool called Sketch. It's time to test it out, so let's get cracking. If this is your first day visiting Tinkercad, of course, it is at tinkercad.com. This is the home. You can also switch to your designs. We're going to simply hit create brand new 3D design. I like to start by naming projects. We're going to call this Sketch V1. I'm going to also give you a little note that Tinkercad saves to the cloud. You can simply back out and boom, everything you've done is saved. All right, so assuming this is your first day with Tinkercad, I'm going to give you some tiny basics first. This is a cube. We build with basic shapes. When you bring them out, you can stretch them, but if you stretch them, you break these handles. I'll show you how that works real quickly. Here's another one. I'm going to give it a radius of 2 and press enter. Notice those corners round perfect. This one that we stretched, I'll give it a radius of 3 and press enter. But then I'm going to show you, boom, those corners are broken. Now notice the height of this one is 52. If I click on this one and change its height to 52, then those parameters stay and it still has that awesome rounded corner. So that's just a quick reminder that handles can be awesome for building something quick, but you do lose the parameters when you do it. Notice these numbers won't match anymore. Where this says 63 over here, it still says 10, even though it's the box that's selected. If I click on this one, those numbers actually match. I'm going to push these to the side, and let's bring out that brand new sketch tool. So the first thing you notice is we get a welcome screen. With the new sketch shape, we can trace 3D shapes in our design to create complex paths quickly with lines and curves. We've been looking for this curve tool forever. Paths are easy to edit and refine as we make precise shapes. The Tinkercad team is still building this, so there will be features added or possibly changed in the future. Don't worry though, the designs we create will stay the same. All right, friends, so with any tool, make sure you read these steps. Right here, they talk about making our shape, creating straight lines, and using awesome curves. So notice this sketch is going to be a skateboard. This is such a wicked cool technique. Once you've got the original shape, you can make the next piece that's going to cut it out. Right here, we switch to curve mode and snap right to the middle. Notice that was lined up. Make our Bezier curve just a little bit past. Click down, and when you hit finish sketch, you can now turn that into a hole, and bingo, you have got the shape you want for your awesome skateboard. Notice once you've got your shapes created, you will have tools so that you can edit it. You can select points, lines, or an entire shape as you move them about your project. You can hold shift to add or remove from your selection. We have got actions that allow us to change corners into smooth curves. Check this out. Simply select them, hit make smooth, and bingo, you have got the matching corners. There are also handles to split, and you can make things into corners. Finally, you can refine shapes by adding and removing points. It's as easy as click and drag as you add points and edit your awesome shape. Of course, once you do that, you can switch it to a curve or whatever you need. Check it out. This is an awesome way to make teeth on, say, your own cool dinosaur. How cool is that? Friends, I'm going to hit continue to sketch, and let's actually build something. Now notice we are first in straight line mode. This is the Bezier curve mode, and this is how you can erase pieces. Just for fun, I'm going to create a swimming pool shape. Now I want this to look something like a kidney bean, so we're going to switch to Bezier. I'm going to click, and then here's the trick. You got to click and hold to make the curve show up. Now I'm going to switch back to straight by just clicking and clicking and clicking, and then I'm going to click and hold. Now remember I said I wanted this to look like a kidney bean. Let me show you how to get it there. So first, notice this one has one handle. If we switch down here, boom, now it's got two handles, and they are connected in, out, whichever way you go. These are joined together. If we go over here, once again, we've got the two handles. We can shrink it, grow it, whatever we want. This one right here, we're going to switch to this choice. Now, this lets us do independent turns. It's super simple to adjust. Of course, you can also click on it and bounce back to the one that's symmetrical, if that's what you prefer as well. So once again, I want to make this into sort of a kidney bean pool. I got to click on this one, make sure it's got the curve I want. I'm going to click on this one, make sure it's a curve as well. Once you've got those in, you can simply adjust to make your pool look however you want. Now, this would be super fun with the little penguin challenge, but you could also use it for making a pond, anything that you want to have a shape where it's got round corners. Bingo, you can build it. I'm going to click finish and let's check out our cool little pool or pond, whatever you want to call it. I could bump up the quality, but I'm going to leave it as it is. I do want to hold down shift scale to make it just a little bit larger. And of course, I'm going to change the depth just like that. All right, so the little pool or pond was fun. Let's make something a little more useful. I'm going to bring this out, and once we get in, we're going to stay with straight lines this time. Once again, I'm just going to click, click, and click, and I'm going to build what I'm going to call a rain gutter. We can simply click and draw the profile. And when we hit finish, bingo, you have instantly got a shape you could use as a rain gutter. So we can finally, what I would have called back in the day, scribble with straight lines. I created a video about scribbling straight a long time ago, and bingo, there it is. Check it out though, let's do this again, this time with curves. Once again, we jump in. Here's our Bezier curve. I'm gonna click, and I'm gonna click and hold. So there's my curve shape, right? Because I choose to stay on this straight line, it'll be symmetrical. If we click the same spot up here, once again, I'm going to move over, click down, hold, get it similar, get it close to how I want. I could be perfect, but I'm going to choose not to, just so I can show you how you can change it later. Now we can click back here and I can say, hey, I want that one to be symmetrical. And this time when I lay it flat, boom, we have got that shape. You can adjust those as much as you want to get it however you like. Once you hit finish though, boom, you have got your shape that you can now use for all kinds of fun things. You can still adjust them just like everything else in Tinkercad, but you can also double click, get back in there, and edit your sketch. How cool is that? All right, friends, let's try tracing a shape. We're gonna bring out this heart. Now, friends, let's bring out our sketch tool. We can set it on top, and we're ready to trace. Now, I wanna make sure I'm on a straight up and down line so that we've got the middle. So I'm coming close to this shape, but not perfect. Now I'm going to do my curves. I'm going to go here and hold. I'm going to go up in this area, hold and stretch. Once again, hold and stretch, and then finish it. Now I can edit these. I'm going to pull this down a chunk, click on this one, make my curves so they match the way I want. Love that rounded shape. And friends, let's finish the sketch. I'm going to delete the old heart, D to drop. And let's do Control D. Move the other one to the other side. Flip it. Do W for work plane and D to drop. Notice I nudged that a little out of place. I'm going to put my work plane back on the ground, L for align. And I just want them aligned like that. And now we can group them. How cool is that? Friends, there you have it. A fun, fast look at the brand new Tinkercad sketch tool. Of course, lots more to come. Make sure you stay tuned. Friends, a quick shout out to my supporters on Patreon. Looking forward to hearing in the discussion group what you're planning on using this. Of course, friends, you can learn more with the link in the description or the bit.ly up above. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you click that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or hit subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.